Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video I'm going to be discussing about tooth numbering systems. There are various systems like universal system, Palmer system, Haderup, FDI, modified FDI. So all these numbering systems, tooth numbering systems, will be discussed in this video. So let's start. Now in tooth numbering system, numbers starting from 1 to 32 along with alphabets and some unique symbols are used to identify the teeth in each quadrant. You know that there are four quadrants, right? First, second, third, fourth quadrant, right? And there are teeth in these quadrants, right? So, to identify these teeth in each quadrant, we use the tooth numbering system. Now the question arises, why do we need this system? So the answer to that is that these systems helps to prevent errors when differentiating between right and left side of the mouth or upper and lower side of the mouth. So basically, to prevent errors or to prevent any kind of confusion so as to what teeth is the person referring to, these systems have been developed. These are fixed notations so that there is no confusion left and people can easily differentiate between the different teeth. It also has advantage when typing and is capable of being incorporated in computer languages. Now there are several systems in the world, but the most widely used ones are universal system, Palmer system, which is also known as Sigmondi system, Haderup FDI, modified FDI, out of which this and this is very important. These are the most widely used systems, out of which FDI is most widely used among these three also. So first let's study about the universal system or the Cunningham system. Now the universal numbering system is also known as American system. Why? Because it is a dental notation that is used in United States. So that is why it is also known as American system. Now here we have the Cunningham system for permanent dentition and for primary dentition. So first let's talk about the permanent dentition. So always remember that the patient's right appears on the left. Patient's right appears on the left side of the chart. So if this is the chart for permanent dentition for universal system, then the left area of the chart, that is this area, right? This is the left area, that is actually the patient's right. So the patient's right side appears on the left side of the chart. So hence we have right here and here we have left, and the patient's left side is actually on the right side of the chart. All right, same goes with this chart also. This is right, and this is left. The labels right and the left on the charts are actually corresponding to the patient's left and right and not on the person who is viewing. So in Cunningham system, both alphabets and numbers are used. For permanent dentition, we use numbers, and for primary dentition, we use alphabets. The uppercase alphabet A through T are used for primary dentition. If you talk about the primary dentition or the deciduous dentition or the teeth that arrive first, then there are alphabets used ranging from A to T. Whereas for permanent dentition, numbers are used ranging from 1 to 32. And how does it start? The numbering starts from the upper left corner. It goes like this: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is the first quadrant, it is finished. Then the second quadrant start: 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. And after that, we move downwards: 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Like this, it goes. So first we go like this, then we go like this, and then we go like this. So this is like a clockwise direction, right? And similarly here in the primary dentition also, it goes like this: A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, then K, and then like this. So here also we have a clockwise direction movement. So what you need to remember is that in universal system, in permanent dentition, the numbers are used, whereas in primary dentition, the alphabets are used, and the numbers and alphabets have to go in a clockwise direction starting from the upper right corner. Alright, now let's talk about the second system, that is the Palmer notation or the Sigmondi system. There are two names used for this, so don't get confused, it is the same thing. The Palmer notation method consists of symbols. These four symbols are used, which designates the quadrant of the tooth, and also numbers are used, which indicate the position of the tooth from the midline. So let's have a look here. First, the permanent teeth. So here in Palmer notation, first symbols as well as numbers are used. Symbol that is used, you know that this is a quadrant, right? So for this quadrant, this symbol is used. For this quadrant, this symbol is used. For this quadrant, this symbol is used. And for this one, this is used. So this is pretty easy, right? And the numbering here does not start from the right upper right corner. It does not go straight. It starts from the midline. If this is the quadrant, then we know that this is the midline. This is called the midline. So the numbering is going to start from this middle line only, right? So it is going to go like this: 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, then like this: 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, similarly 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So it goes like this, and we have these four symbols to differentiate the quadrants. Adult teeth are numbered from 1 to 8, while primary teeth or the baby teeth here, if you look, they are indicated by the alphabets and not numbers. So it goes from A B C D E A B C D E. I hope you know that there are 8 teeth in each quadrants, right? And what are those 8 teeth? The teeth are central incisors, lateral incisors, canines, first premolars, second premolars, first molar, second molar, and third molar. So how many are these? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So there are 8 teeth in each quadrant. So we have 8 teeth here, 8 here, 8 here, and 8 here. Whereas in case of deciduous teeth or the primary teeth, we only have 5 teeth. And what are those 5 teeth? We have central incisors, lateral incisors, we have canines, but there are no premolars, right? And then we have the first molar and the second molar. So there are only 5 teeth in case of deciduous teeth. So we have only 5 here, and here we have a total of 8 teeth. So I hope you understood the Palmer's system also. Now let's move on to Hadarov system, which is very much similar to the Palmer notation, except for only one change, that a plus and minus sign is used to designate the upper and lower. In Palmer system, we were using these symbols, right? But in Hadarov system, we are going to use plus and minus sign. If you look at this picture, if you talk about the permanent teeth, we can see that similarly 1 to 8 teeth are going from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. But instead of this sign, we are having this plus sign. Plus sign is used for the upper teeth. All the teeth in the upper portion are having the plus sign, and the ones in the lower jaw are denoted by a minus sign. The same case is here with the temporary teeth also. That is, a plus sign is used to denote upper teeth, and the minus sign is used in lower teeth. But here's a difference also. In Palmer notation, what we were using for temporary teeth was the alphabets, but here we do not use alphabets. For deciduous teeth, a zero was additionally placed in front of the number. So everything is same as the permanent one, except for there's a zero placed in front of all the numbers, right? So this is the only difference. This notation was adopted by Scandinavian countries. Now let's talk about the FDI system. FDI is two-digit system, and the full form of FDI is Fédération Dentaire Internationale, or also known as FDI, World Dental Federation Notation System, is commonly used for numbering and naming of teeth throughout the world. The system uses two numbers, hence the name FDI two-digit system, for location and naming of each tooth. Now the jaw is divided into four quadrants. We know that the first number refers to the quadrant of a tooth. So here if you see, this is our quadrant. So in this case, The upper right quadrant is the first quadrant. So this is upper right, then this is upper left, then this is lower left, and this is lower right. Alright. So in this case, what we do is, this is a two digit system, right? So there has to be two digits. So this digit is always the quadrant that the teeth is present in. So for all these tooth, the first digit is always going to be 1. For all these, the first digit is always going to be 4, right? 4, as you can see here. Similarly, 2 for this quadrant and 3 for this quadrant. So first thing is sorted. Now let's talk about the second one. So the second is same as the one that we studied in the Palmer notation. From the midline, we just have to go towards the end, right? Like this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This was the case for the permanent teeth. But for primary teeth, what we have is everything is exactly the same, just that the first digit is going to change. Here we were having 1, 2, 3, 4 quadrants, whereas for primary teeth we are having 5, 6, 7, 8 quadrants. So this is the 5th quadrant, 6th quadrant, 7th quadrant and 8th quadrant. And similarly, the second digit is going to be starting from the midline, we are going to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, similarly 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this only. So I hope you understood the FDI two digit system also. Then there's a small modification system also available for FDI. In this, the tooth and the quadrant are designated by different numbers. The right quadrant is designated by 2 and 3 and the left quadrant is designated by 1 and 4. So earlier in FDI, what we had was 1, 2, 3 and 4. These were the quadrants name, right? So, and this is the right quadrant, this is the left quadrant, right? This was the case. But in modified system, what we are having is that the right quadrant are designated by 2 and 3. Here you can see they were designated by 1 and 4, but in modified they are designated by 2 and 3, right? This is the right. And for the left quadrants, they are designated by 1 and 4. So in a way, they are, you know, switched, right? They are the opposite. So this was for FDI and this is for modified FDI. So this was all about tooth numbering systems. I hope you understood each and every one of them. Thank you for watching this video.